Hi everyone, Succulents Box here again, and today we're going to teach you how you can make your very own jellyfish succulent and transform your simple garden into a beautiful aquarium. For those of you who aren't aware, jellyfish succulent is simply a cluster of different succulent varieties put together in a hanging basket to create a unique appearance that looks exactly like a jellyfish in a hanging succulent pot. To make a jellyfish succulent, you need, number one, at least two types of succulents. One can either be a trailing plant or any air plant to make the tentacles, and the other could be an echeveria or any rosette-shaped succulent for the body of your jellyfish. Number two, the right type of hanging basket, one that can almost achieve the round body of a jellyfish. Number three, garden clothes, felt, thin wire, and needle to help hold your jellyfish in place. And of course, a well-draining soil. Once we have all the materials we need, we can now start making our own jellyfish succulent. The first thing you need to do is to fill your moss basket or whatever basket you're using with succulent or cactus soil nearly to the top. You can also apply fertilizer if you'd like. Next is to plant at least 5 trailing succulents or air plants a couple of inches in front of the trim of the basket. Once you're done, you need to cover the bottom of the hanger with a felt to help secure your jellyfish succulent in place when you flip over later. This is very important, especially when the soil gets heavy after watering. Now, you can plant at least 5 to 6 flowering succulents of your choice inside the basket. Make sure to give each of the succulents enough space to grow and create a bulbous look for the jellyfish. Once you're done, make sure that your succulents are secure and that the soil won't fall onto the ground before turning the basket over. After that, you should start seeing your jellyfish trail lengthening and the top blossoming in just a span of a few weeks. When watering your jellyfish succulents, the most important thing you need to keep in mind is that this plant is made mostly out of succulents, meaning it can easily get root rot when overwatered. So to make sure that you're just giving your jellyfish succulent the right amount of water it needs, water it thoroughly, at least once or twice every 2 weeks, depending on how fast the soil dries. But every winter season, most succulents go dormant. Cut back with your watering to once a month. Avoid wetting the rosettes whenever you water your jellyfish. Instead, water it between the plants, directly onto the moss. Again, since this plant is made out of succulents, it's gonna need a lot of sunlight to thrive, as well as maintain its colors. You can grow it outside on your porch, balcony, or deck, where it can receive at least 5 to 6 hours of morning sunlight. And that's all for today. Hope you guys enjoyed and found these tips useful in making your own jellyfish succulents. We'll see you again next time.
For more, you can find us at succulentsbox.com or on YouTube, TikTok, Facebook, Instagram, and Pinterest.